is my room. I belong here. I know the combination. I carry it with me. I know that number. Where's that from? I did this. I wrote that.
Detective, I have made many discoveries in my case. The child we want is safe, thanks to good people like me and you. We're so similar, but you don't see all the things I do. To find your man, Jeremy, you also need to look for the girl. It has always been that way. The young deliver us all. You should have a look in my room. There's a piece of the puzzle you will need. Take care now. My coffee.
How long have I been here? I recognize this view.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside. Why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing his shame? If so, couldn't she have just made another drawing?
What the hell happened in here?
Thank you. The empty room always felt familiar. It had a mild fragrance of crushed leaves and wet sand that somehow convinced visitors that they belonged. It wasn't real, of course, but it was more real than many other things you could find.
This looks familiar. How am I back at the office? Jeremy's never been here.
He was back in the French Quarter. His office, to be exact. A place Jeremy had certainly never seen. It could only mean that the dark man had reached inside Edward's mind and conjured this place for him to suffer.
Me, isn't it?
How long have it been since I drowned myself in drink and depression? And it all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. A welcoming dark voice wrapped around my mind like a heavy blanket. It turned off suddenly as I woke up from the sound of my office door closing shut. A messenger had left a telegram for Mrs. Saunders. She had a lead on where to find her husband and her kidnapped daughter. God, I used to drink so. Much back then. When was this exactly? What case was I working? I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state, but he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so.
Carnby vaguely remembered the case of the missing child. She was kidnapped by her estranged father. There was some connection to a gallerist named Thornhill, a painting sold to pay for a getaway.
Thank you.
can't go that way.
Principles keeping him from handing out information about his yields, so it needed some convincing. Well, every case can't be squeaky clean. Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out. Say it didn't happen. I can't go that way. Thank you.
I'm all...
The kidnapper had sold a painting to Thornhill, the collector, to pay for a car and enough gas to get out of Louisiana. Detective Carnby was suddenly reminded of shaking him down to find out where the kidnapper was hiding. St. George's Hotel by the park.
Can't go that way.
On my way to the hotel, the Morton gang caught up with me. I owed them money, a lot of them. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. I found it. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting of the signature, Ted Stryker. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room.
Something. That name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. Recognize this room, but I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them, but where? That's right, he was running away, ditching his old life and marriage in New Orleans to find something better in Tallahassee. And he took his daughter with him against the will of the mother. That's why she hired me. But I stopped him. I caught up with him at the Pearl River Bridge.
Detective Carnby didn't recognize the bridge across Pearl River. It was firmly obfuscated by trauma. Events that had left Carnby scarred for life.
Pearl River. This is where I caught up with them. This is what the dark man wanted me to revisit. But I'm still not seeing it. What am I forgetting? Thank you.
I can't believe I didn't recognize him.
I looked a little different back then, I suppose.
Was any of this real?
How do you mean?
This day, just... so much is happening. I can't... I think I've lost my head. Do you need me to apologize? I mean... I am sorry. I don't think I can even begin to explain. You're just a kid, Grace. I'm really sorry. I didn't mean for it to happen.
Lies. More lies.
No, really. I thought I was being a good guy by handing you over to your mother. I didn't know. I couldn't have known that she wouldn't care about you.
I don't know how this works. What is this for?
Some form of admission of guilt. Maybe acceptance. That's what the dark man wants.
I guess we just watch my father die again, then.
You think he's alive?
I know he is. He's down there, scared that he won't be able to get out. That he will drown with his daughter again.
What are you saying? We gotta save him!
We? Do it yourself! I'm down there with him, remember?
Can I really save them? This all happened so long ago. I have to find a way to get down there. I have to see it with my own eyes. There was a boat at the house where I entered. If I can raise the bridge, I should be able to get to the car.
Carnby had run their car off the bridge. He pulled Grace out of the sinking car, but left her father to drown. He could have saved him. There was time. He just chose not to. Instead, he took Grace back to New Orleans and collected his paycheck.
There must be a way to save you both, right? Why else would I be here?
Maybe the dark man just likes it when you suffer.
Don't worry, kid. I'll think of something.
I'm not holding my breath.
Thank you.
This must be where the bridge is operated. Nothing's happening. It's like something's holding it back.
Are you okay?
Don't leave me alone.
What the hell have you been doing?
What's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry, Mrs. Thompson.
Don't make me kick you out of this house! Now get out!
Hey, Detective. Mr. Carnby. I'm really worried about you.
I'm okay. I just need to catch my breath for a moment.
This place, it's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Dracetto has a deranging effect on people. I think it might explain... things.
What?
Just take it easy, okay? I'm gonna go find a way into Dr. Gray's apartment. I wanna know what he's hiding.
Emily, don't worry. I think I'm close. I'm gonna set everything right.
Just be careful.
Carnby had run their car off the bridge. He pulled Grace out of the sinking car, but left her father to drown. He could have saved him. There was time. He just chose not to. Instead, he took Grace back to New Orleans and collected his paycheck.